Nick Wallenda, ladies and gentlemen, has made history. He is the first human to ever cross the Grand Canyon on a wire. Nick, congratulations.
Thank you.
How are you feeling, man?
Emotional.
I can see that.
Can I get some water? It was way more windy, and the movement of the cable and the sidewalls as I was walking were getting in the way and confusing me as the pendulums were swinging against them. So I'd try to react, and when I reacted, I'd kick that rhythm into the cable, and it took every bit of me to stay focused that entire time. My arms are aching like you wouldn't believe.
Here you go. Take a sip of water.
Open this for you. We don't want you to strain those arms any further. Now, twice, Nick, we saw you go down to the wire to get the balance.
Well, I was building a huge rhythm in the cable, and I had to sit down to hopefully take that rhythm out. That was the only thing I could do, is what happens, as I talked about, you can put a rhythm in that cable. And if I didn't go down and kept walking, it was just getting worse. And it was totally an optical illusion. You know, you guys talked about it leading up to this, and the fact that those pendulums swinging this way, and the cable moving this way, and a wall that's solid, really was confusing for me to see, to have anything to focus on that I can counterbalance off of.
Were you fatigued by halfway point? It looked like you were getting
tired. I was fatigued until I was three quarters of the way all across, and then it was just all adrenaline.